Hi there, Doug Stimmon with IT Creations, with one of Lenovo's compact workstations that still delivers some considerable punch, the Lenovo ThinkStation P3 Ultra. It has the same case dimensions as its predecessor, the P360 Ultra workstation I did in January of 2023, and you can see that video here. Just a few short months after that review, the P3 Ultra was announced. Yeah, this review might be just a tad late. The P3 Ultra still fits in nicely with the larger P-series tower siblings. Sporting tower features with a single Intel Core CPU, up to 128 gigabytes of memory, terabytes of storage, and room for a single Ada series GPU. You can still even connect monitors without a discrete GPU. If you like our videos, hit that subscribe button. Let's get to it. It's probably a little smaller than an insulated lunchbox you pack for your kid, or maybe you use one for your own lunch at work. Very portable for taking home, going to the office. Perfect for remote locations if you have a monitor or several to connect it to, as it will support up to 8. I mean, this thing is tiny. It's 9 inches by 8 inches by 3.5 inches. Or if you like liquid measurements, 3.9 liters. It's also loaded with a bunch of ports front and back for great connectivity options. ISV certified for a number of applications from Adobe, Autodesk, Altair, Bentley, Dassault, and others. And why wouldn't it be? It's a workstation. With credentials like that, this system can be used for architecture, engineering, construction, media and entertainment, analytics, and a host of other disciplines. It's also very easy to upgrade. Need more performance? Then check out my other reviews for the ThinkStations P5, P7, P8, and PX. I placed a few links below. As you watch this video, keep in mind it's about the fourth quarter of 2024. There are many pre-configured options for this system. With a bare bones configuration, the ThinkStation P3 Ultra starts at a little over $1,200. We specifically have the configuration 30HA003BUS, which is definitely more than a base model, with a cost listed at a little over $5,000. Of course, you can build your own spec too. This system can sit upright like a mini tower, or it can be placed on its side, as there are little rubberized feet for both options. On the front of the system, power on button, headphones jack, USB Type-A port with 10 gigabit per second data transfer rate, and two Thunderbolt 4 Type-C ports offering data transfer rates of up to 40 gigabits per second, with one always on for charging. Nice. Are you interested in this little Lenovo ThinkStation P3 Ultra? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed, or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. That's right, just click that link right there, and you could be mixing it up with a configuration option tailored to your specifications. Don't really know what those are? We can help with that too. Just remember to mention this video when you're ready to make a purchase to reap the rewards. ITCreations.com. More ports on the back include two RJ45 Ethernet ports, one with 1 gigabit Ethernet and the other with 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. Next, three DisplayPort 1.4 ports, which are supported by the Intel Core i5, i7, or i9 processors that can be installed on this unit, specifically those with integrated graphics. And yes, it does take 14th generation Intel Core processors too, but we'll get to that. You can install additional expansion cards and ports using two PCI slots. As you can see, one of those PCI slots is filled with a GPU with four mini display ports. We also have a 300 watt, 90% efficient PSU installed on the system. Other options include 230 watts and 170 watts. Power requirements will really depend on how this system is outfitted. That said, you will need a large PSU if you intend on installing a GPU. You get four more USB Type-A ports in back, again with a 10 gigabit per second data transfer rate, and right next to the power connector, an antenna for Wi-Fi. Push the depression on that little lever and it pops out a bit so you can grab it and pull the guts out of the system. That little antenna connects to the wireless LAN module on the system board. A little M.2 drive looking thing provides Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth 5.1. That slot is dedicated for Wi-Fi connectivity. Wi-Fi 7 is also supported with a small legalese description to tell when it's not. Components are loaded on both sides of the motherboard, which has a very clever design that has not changed since the ThinkStation P360. On one side, a small plastic shroud with integrated fan for the CPU, and then the GPU beside it also with integrated fan, along with two memory module slots. Two more memory module slots on the other side, along with another small cooling shroud with integrated fan to keep the two NVMe M.2 drives cool. Fans are easily removable and replaceable in the event one goes south. Two PCI slots include one PCI 4.0 by 16 slot and one PCI 3.0 by 8 slot with a x4 lane. That first for the GPU, as it is a by 16 lane, but also supports 75 watts of power. Only 25 watts of power supported on the by 8 slot. Installed in this unit is the 13th generation Intel Core i13900 processor with 24 physical cores, including 8 performance or P cores and 16 efficient or E cores, plus 32 virtual threads. The motherboard is also compatible with 12th and 14th generation Intel Core processors. The P cores operate at a base frequency of 5.2 GHz and the E cores at 4.2 GHz. Max Turbo Boost is up at 5.6 GHz. Offering a balance of power with the P cores for complex performance and single-threaded applications like gaming and work-related activities, the E cores are for multi-threaded applications and background tasks, also providing better thermals and power efficiency. Yes, you can play just as hard as you work with those P cores. I think I should have switched that around. You can work just as hard as you play with those P cores. Intel's integrated thread director determines the type of cores best suited to managing the workload and dynamically distributes the information accordingly. P cores have Intel's hyper-threading technology, while the E cores do not. Still, we have 32 virtual threads on the CPU. Perhaps the E cores don't support hyper-threading technology, maybe just threading technology. I'm thinking that 16 virtual threads from 8 physical P cores and just mirroring the 16 physical E cores for 16 more virtual threads, delivering a total of 32 virtual threads as listed in the specs. With no letter suffix on the end of the 13th gen Core i9-13900, this is a standard desktop CPU and supports integrated graphics. There are other N-letter suffix CPUs offered too. T is for efficiency and basic desktop computing. T also supports integrated graphics. F means no integrated graphics and has a locked base frequency, so no overclocking. F will require a discrete graphics card because no integrated graphics. K means it's unclocked and can still be overclocked, but it does have integrated graphics. A great choice if you want to hook up an 8-monitor setup, which is possible on this system. The KF suffix, of which none are listed, but I thought I would throw them in anyways, do not have integrated graphics. KF suffix CPUs do have overclocking just like the K suffix. They also are slightly less expensive, and as a result, KF suffix CPUs are preferred by gamers and those looking for performance, and definitely plan on installing a GPU. With iGPU, or integrated graphics support, you get either UHD graphics 770 or 730 depending on the CPU. All of that to say, with integrated graphics, the system can use the 3 integrated DisplayPort 1.4 ports on the back and the 2 Thunderbolt ports on the front. Only 4 monitors though with the integrated graphics option. I know, that's 5 ports. With a trusted platform module, the system supports Windows 11 Pro and home versions, plus Ubuntu and Red Hat Enterprise Linux operating systems. The TPM module was one of the limiting factors when I tried to upgrade my old, well, actually ancient PC, to Windows 11. No TPM, no Windows 11. Outfitted with Lenovo's ThinkShield security solution, which works with Windows 11 Pro, businesses are covered with an end-to-end system to deal with vulnerabilities as they arise. It offers both a hardware and software security solution. Thanks to AI-powered endpoint protection, ThinkShield adapts and evolves to counter today's threats and those you will likely encounter in the future. That negates the fact that most people these days think AI is where that threat will originate, but that's beside the point. I mean, look at the Terminator film franchise. There's the bad ones trying to end your future, then the good AIs out to protect your best interests. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference. I'm kidding, but am I? You can also access the system remotely using the ThinkStation BMC remote management console, but for that you will need to install an expansion card in one of the 2 PCI slots, that by 8 slot. Intel vPro Enterprise is another useful option for businesses that may need secure out-of-band management. There's also the Vantage app to help diagnose problems with the ThinkStation. It's pre-installed, just type Vantage in the Windows search window. In this particular configuration, the 30HA003BUS, we have the NVIDIA RTX 8000 12GB graphics card. It features Ampere architecture and is at the lower end of the stack of what's offered. The top offerings include the RTX 4000 Ada generation SFF with 20GB of GDDR6 and the Ampere architecture RTX A5500 mobile GPU with 16GB of GDDR6 memory. The 13th gen Intel Core i9-13900 processor we already discussed. 1 2TB M.2 Opal drive and 2 32GB SODIMM memory modules for 64GB of non-ECC DDR5 4800MHz memory. ECC memory is also supported. At full capacity, up to 128GB of memory can be installed. Now back to those GPUs. The RTX A2000 was also featured in the Lenovo ThinkStation P360 Ultra video and we did some benchmarks for that card along with the A5000, so we'll have to take a peek at those results maybe a week or two after we post this video for comparison. I mean, it is the same GPU, so don't expect much. That said, we do have a different processor. As I recall, we did have a slight malfunction with the A5000 card. It was resolved, but not before we released the video. We never did benchmark that one. The RTX A2000 has a power draw of 70 watts, second generation RT cores and third generation Tensor cores. If this was the NVIDIA RTX 4000 SFF Ada, then it would be sporting 20 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory, third generation RT cores and fourth generation Tensor cores. Fourth gen Tensor cores are functionally identical to those in the Hopper H100 microarchitecture. The H100 is currently the GPU of choice for AI, machine learning, and deep learning applications. Remember, this is 2024. This system can support up to 8 simultaneous displays. That'd be connecting 4 monitors using the 3 integrated display ports, along with 2 Thunderbolt ports, then 4 more displays using a discrete GPU. In this case, our RTX A2000 with 4 mini DisplayPort 1.4a. Resolutions supported include 4K and 5K at 60Hz refresh, and up to 5K at 120Hz refresh, with graphics supplied by one of the top-end CPUs. There are only 2 NVMe M.2 slots on the system board, which Lenovo says will only support up to 256GB to 4TB each. They have aluminum heat sinks, which are then covered by a plastic shroud with integrated fan for additional heat dissipation. You can also install one 2.5-inch SATA HDD for up to 1TB more, or go with a 2.5-inch SSD for up to 7.68TB of storage. That will bring us to 15.68TB with a 2.5-inch SSD and 2 4TB NVMe M.2 drives. However, that capacity figure may be debatable based on when the system was vetted and what was available when it was released. The 2.5-inch drive is mounted opposite the 2 M.2 storage modules and thermal kit. I will note that even with all the separate shrouds with integrated fans for the CPU, GPU, and M.2 drives, the system is surprisingly quiet. Integrated RAID controllers support RAID 0 and RAID 1. RAID 0 for better performance, and RAID 1 for 1+1 redundancy and data resilience. I do hope you enjoyed this short overview of the Lenovo ThinkStation P3 Ultra Workstation, offering impressive performance, support for up to 128GB of memory, and substantial storage at a little over 15TB, allegedly. This is a flexible, portable, and powerful platform for both complex applications and gaming, depending on how you configure the system. Stay tuned for the benchmarks, as I do think my long-winded descriptions have already bored several of you into submission. If you are still on board, hit that subscribe button to get notified when we post the benchmarks, probably in a week or two. Need one or several of these little gems? Try itcreations.com using one of the links in the description, or that one right there. Until next time, I'm Doug Stewart with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.